So we have seen that our predict not taken predictor, that is very simple to implement, is pretty accurate. For about 88% of all instructions, it predicts correctly. So why do we even need any better predictors? Because anything better than this will require some investment of hardware to do the prediction better. We will answer this question in two ways. First, we will compare the CPI with the not taken predictor, that is, let's say, 88% accurate, and with a better predictor, that is, let's say, 99% accurate. And we will do this for a five-stage pipeline that resolves branches in the third stage, so it has a two-cycle penalty whenever there is a misprediction. So it has a two-cycle penalty when there is a misprediction. We will also do it for a 14-stage pipeline that resolves branches in the 11th stage, so it has a 10-cycle penalty for a misprediction. And for another pipeline that has 14 stages, resolves branches in 11th stage, but this one executes 4 instructions per cycle. So this is very close to what modern processors look like. So for a not taken predictor and a 5-stage pipe, the CPI we get is 1 plus how often we mispredict, which is 12% of all instructions, times the penalty of a misprediction, which is 2 cycles, which gives us a total CPI of 1.24. What happens when we have a better predictor? Well, we now get 1 plus 0.01, only 1% of the time we mispredict, and we get a 2-cycle penalty then. So the CPI now is 1.02. And now let's look also at the speed up that we get from a better predictor. If the frequency of the processor stays the same and it executes the same number of instructions, then the speed up is simply the improvement in the CPI. So the speed up would be the CPI of the not taken predictor divided by the CPI of the better predictor. And we get a speed up of 1.22. So this is actually a noticeable speed up. But things get more interesting when we have a deeper pipeline. In that case, we have 1 plus, still 12% accuracy for not taken, but this time the penalty, because we resolve branches in 11th stage, will be 10. And we get an overall CPI of 2.2. This is much worse than the one we would be getting with no mispredictions. With our better predictor, we get 1 plus 1% misprediction rate times 10 for a total CPI of 1.1, and that gives us a speed up of 2. So as we can see now, the better predictor is giving us twice the performance of the not taken predictor. And we have seen this already, that the deeper the pipeline, the more benefit we get from a better predictor. But what happens when we also do multiple instructions per cycle? So this processor can do 4 instructions in a cycle, so the ideal cycles per instruction is 1/4 of a cycle. We add to that how often we have mispredictions times how many cycles do we waste for a misprediction. We still detect mispredictions in the 11th stage, so everything done in the 10 cycles after the branch was fetched is wasted, so we still have a 10-cycle penalty here. And we get an overall CPI of 1.45. That's actually less than one instruction per cycle. It's better than a single instruction per cycle processor, but not that much better for something that should be 4 times as capable. Now let's look at the better predictor, which should give us the ideal CPI plus 1% of the time 10-cycle penalty, and that results in a CPI of 0.35, or about 3 instructions per cycle even with the branches. If we compute the speed up, it's 4.14. So as you can see, if we have a deeper pipeline, or if we are able to execute more instructions per cycle, then the better predictor is more important than in simpler processors.